Like, does this mean you guys hate each other?
No, sweetheart, we don't hate each other. It's just that the separation made us realize we don't want to be together anymore.
You're sure this time?
Yes, I'm sure.
I don't think Daddy's so sure.
Well,
I don't get it.
What?
If you're such a big expert, how come you couldn't work it out?
You know, Angie, that's a good question. And all I can say is, people change.
Wait a minute, sweetie. I'll give you some help. Okay? Ah, got it.
Righty. I'll see you Sunday, all right?
You call me.
Okay. Hi, Daddy.
You're late. Hi, sweetheart. Why don't you go inside, okay? I'll be in a minute. I got the papers today.
I know.
I haven't signed them yet.
Max, please, I don't want to go through this every time we see each other.
I love you, Julie, and I want you to reconsider. I think that I can change.
I'm not asking you to change, Max. This is who you are.
After everything I've done for you.
Well, maybe that's just it. Maybe you've done too much. Now it's time I started running my own life.
You're listening to WRAP Rap Radio, Ithaca, New York.
Nobody likes getting hurt, Marissa. But the alternative is to live in isolation, completely cut off from the world, and I don't think that's the answer. Do you?
No.
No, it isn't. So that's why you gotta get out there, and you gotta take chances.
I'll try.
Oh, good for you. That's all I ask.
Thanks for the help.
Well, thank you, Marissa, and good luck. Good evening, you're on the air with Julianne Kaiser, and tonight's topic is starting over.
Who am I talking to? How can I help you? Hello?
Hi, my name is Nathaniel.
What can I do for you, Nat?
I was wondering just how it is
you do get started after you've been out of circulation for 25 years.
25 years? Wow, that's a long time. Where have you been for 25 years?
I was unavailable.
You mean you were married?
No, I never had a chance for that. I was locked up in a cell all that time.
Set up for someone else's crime.
Really?
Yeah, it was tough.
But I'm out now, and I'm gonna set things right.
Set things right? What do you mean by that, Nat?
Well, I think you know what I mean, Julie.
You've been dreading this day for 25 years.
Sorry about the crank. Forget it. The night wouldn't be complete without a crackpot or two.
Drink?
Yeah. On the one hand, I'm excited. I mean, I feel as if the divorce is a break of my entire past. But on the other hand, I'm scared to death.
Of what, Dee Dee?
No, it's just that Max and I have been together almost since grade school. I mean, he's it.
You're kidding. You mean Max has been the only one?
Not exactly. I mean, the first time that Max and I separated, I did meet a guy. And we spent a couple of pretty wild weeks together.
Okay, so what's his number?
Oh, Sue, you are terrible.
You look scared to death.
I think I'm getting a migraine. You know, this divorce is stirring up a lot of memories.
Here's stuff, baby.
Order!
Now tell me, Julie, is the man you saw that night in the courtroom today?
Hello? Hello?
Yes. That man. There.
Hello?
Hi.
Oh, hi.
Did I wake you?
No, I'm up.
Lloyd, something's happening.
What? Who is it?
It's my sister.
What?
I think that I saw Parmenter tonight.
Oh, come on, Julie. The guy got 25 years to life.
But that's what I'm trying to tell you. It's been 25 years.
You're right.
Yeah. You don't know how I've been dreading this day.
Well, where's Angie?
She's spending the night at Max's.
Look, you want me to come over?
Oh, no, it's okay. I'll be all right. I'm sorry that I woke you.
You sure you don't want me to come over?
No, I'm fine. Don't worry about it.
Listen, Jules, nothing's gonna happen, okay?
I want you to stop worrying.
Yeah, but I'm the one that testified against him. I'm the one that got him put away.
So I'm not crazy?
No. You're not crazy. You're the farthest thing from it. You're just grieving. I'll see you next week, okay? Hi, Billy. How are you?
Great.
Good. Come on in.
So, tell me about your week.
You look really pretty today, Dr. Kaiser.
We're here to talk about you, Billy.
Good evening. You're on the air with Julianne Kaiser, and tonight's topic is emotional baggage. Who am I talking to, and how can I help you?
Yeah. Hi, my name is Carolyn. I'm just emotionally.
What?
I made something special for you.
Not hungry now.
Happy, honey. And it's your favorite. Roast chicken with the skin all crispy the way you like it.
Not now, Ma.
You've got to assume responsibility for your own problems. You got to learn to deal with your own emotional baggage.
Where are you going, honey?
Going out.
My baby's going out at this hour.
I got a job, Ma.
A job already? What kind of job?
Well, kind of an angel. An avenging angel.
Hi. Oh, thank you much. I've only been waiting here 45 minutes. Yeah? What'd you forget? No, I've got the car. I can come by and pick you up. This is it. Excuse me. I'm talking on the phone here.
What?
No, it's no problem. What are you doing? Hey!
Who am I talking to, and how can I help you?
Hi, my name is David.
Hi, David. What's on your mind?
Well, I've been carrying around a bunch of that emotional baggage, as you call it. Only the trouble is the bags belong to somebody else.
Well, who do they belong to, David?
They belong to you, Julie. I think it's time you took them back.
Mine?
Yeah. Isn't there something you want to tell me?
I don't think so. I don't know what you're talking about, David.
I'm talking about confession, Julie. It's not something I put any stock in, but you should think about it.
Because it's traditional to confess just before you die.
Must be a full moon out tonight. Good evening. You're on the air with Julie Ann Kaiser. Tonight's topic is emotional baggage.
What?
Parmenter was released on Monday.
Oh, God, I don't believe this.
Lloyd?
Yeah, I'll be right in.
They said that it was a model prisoner.
Lloyd?
Yeah, all right. I'm... Let me just take
okay.
it. What's the matter?
It was Parmenter. He followed me here.
You sure?
Damn it, Lloyd, it was Parmenter. I saw him.
Okay, tell you what. First thing tomorrow, we're gonna make a little visit to our friendly neighborhood cops, okay?
Yeah.
It's okay.
Who is it?
I'm coming to get you, Julie.
This is, Lloyd Carson.
Oh.
And, his sister, Julie Kaiser.
It's, it's a pleasure to meet you. Why don't you sit down? What can we do for you?
They want to file a complaint against a,
John Parmenter.
Parmenter, right. Parmenter, the man was released from Blairstown last week, and it seems like these two have a little history again.
Hello?
Julie.
Yes?
It's Michael.
Michael?
I'm parked across the street. You want to let me in for a minute?
Sure, yeah, come on up.
Spent the last 2 years wondering when I was going to run into you.
Has it been that long?
You want to fix me a drink?
I gotta leave for work in an hour.
Make it a short one.
I guess I owe you an explanation.
What happened to Max?
Separated.
Yeah? Like last time?
No, not like last time. This time it's really over.
I'd almost forgotten how beautiful you are. How come you never told me about your mom and dad?
When did I have time to tell you? As I recall it, we knew each other for 2.5 weeks, and we spent most of it in bed.
You want to talk about it now?
No. I never want to talk about it.
Dr. Julian Kaiser will be with you again tomorrow night at 5 after the news on WRAD Rap Radio.
This is Eddie Frierson, the coach, with sports on WRAP. Last night with a full slate of college basketball. We're just going to run down the scores for you right now.
Yeah, these eyes and this awful, awful tattoo. I still get chills when I think about him. He slept in this tiny room next to the tool shed. I was in my room changing, and I looked up, and he was outside in the yard staring at me through the window.
God, that's creepy.
Yeah. I told my mother about it, and my father went outside and gave Parmenter until morning to clear out. And then later that night, that's when it happened.
You know, this is so strange. I mean, you always seem to have it so together.
Sure. Well, it just goes with the territory.
You want to stay at my place tonight?
Yeah, thanks. Oh, I'll see you tomorrow.
Old. This is embarrassing.
Not another word.
Look, I thought we had a deal.
Well, we did, but unfortunately, the price is on the tiles.
Oh, the price is on the tiles now. Look, I don't want to hear any of that. You understand? You gave me a quote 60 days ago, and you're not going to change it on me now.
Look, Mr. Carson, all I'm saying is that I've got no...
No. I want my tiles by Friday. The original price. And if I don't get them, I'm coming after you.
I'll see what I can do.
I'm going to get you. Get out of here.
Hey!
Hey, yourself.
Go! Go! Pick me! That's number one!
Woo! Why, they got dying gone to heaven.
Woo! Woo! Hey, hey! You animals, knock it off. It's my little sister.
What brings you around?
I'm on my way to Bradford.
Bradford?
Mm-hmm.
What's in Bradford?
Dr. Petrie.
Going to see Petrie? What for? You haven't seen her in years.
I know, but I need to talk to her, Lloyd. Tie up a few loose ends.
So, you want me to take you up there?
I'll be fine.
You sure?
Mm-hmm. Petrie, you haven't changed a bit.
Oh, I'm an old retired lady now. But there's always room in my heart for you. Please, go in.
Thank you. Well, then why am I so scared? Why do I feel so vulnerable?
It's a little girl inside you. She's back. You know, when I first met you, Julie, right after the murders, I helped that little girl face unimaginable horrors. But you're a woman now. Maybe the woman hasn't quite come to terms with that frightened little girl.
I don't know.
Angie! I knew a little girl like you once. She's real sweet on the outside, but inside she was evil.
Get lost, creep.
I think recovered memories are a crock. If you buy into that whole crazy business, there isn't a woman in this country who hasn't been molested by her father.
So what's your theory on the subject?
Me?
Yeah.
Well, I think the things that you remember, real or imagined, are much less important than the things you choose not to remember.
You mean the things that we repress?
Exactly.
So what are you repressing, Derek?
My desire to ask you out.
We'll keep on repressing it. Good evening, you're on the air with Julianne Kaiser. Tonight's topic is recovered memories. Go ahead, please.
Hi, Julie. My name is Paul.
Hi, Paul.
And something happened to me earlier today that brought back a flood of memories.
Well, tell us about it.
I was walking by a school this morning.
Uh-huh.
Right around recess, I saw three pretty little girls in the schoolyard skipping rope.
Uh-huh.
Well, one of them, the prettiest one, reminded me of a girl I knew a long time ago. She was real sweet on the outside, but she had the devil inside her.
That's weird.
What's weird?
And you know what's sad?
There was this man at school today.
What?
Outside the playground. He knew my name.
There's already been so much tragedy in this family.
He said almost the exact same thing.
And now that little girl is gonna lose her mother.
We're gonna take a break now for a sports update. Please stay tuned. We'll be right back with more.
Julie. Why didn't you tell me Parnell had been released?
Because I thought that I could handle it myself.
Damn it, Julie. Angie is my daughter, too.
What are you saying? Do you think that I would ever let anything happen to her? I have done everything humanly possible, from going to the police, to notifying her school, to being there with her when a bus shows up in the morning. The last thing I need from you is any of your constant self-righteous criticism.
You are never going to change, are you?
What?
Because this is the way you deal with everything, by not dealing with it. You just bury it.
I don't have to take this from you, Max. You don't run my life anymore. Angie, sweetie, come on. We're leaving. Get your things.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye, sweetie.
Danny, huh?
I thought we weren't keeping secrets from each other.
He's just a friend, Ma.
Dr. Kaiser, it's Howard Albright again, WNTS New York. I'm sorry to trouble you at home, but we're going to be in town on unrelated business Thursday, and we need to talk seriously about luring you away from Ithaca. Please call at your earliest convenience. You have the number.
What's that all about?
A national job. A big one.
You mean, like, people could hear you all over the whole country?
Mm-hmm.
You could get as famous as Howard Stern.
Not that fast. Come on. Bedtime. You get the light?
You're surprised to see me. I've been thinking about you every day for the last 25 years.
Get out of my way.
You better start looking over your shoulder. Judgment Day is near.
Mrs. Parmenter.
What do you want? Why don't you leave my boy alone? It's her. Her you should be after. My boy wouldn't hurt a fly. Oh, she convinced them all right, sitting up there in the witness stand in her pretty little dress. But I know what really happened that night. There was no one in the house but her.
You tell him I want to talk to him. Come on.
Like mother, like son.
Yeah. Got everything, hon?
Yep.
Oh.
What's your day like tomorrow, Dr. Kaiser?
What?
Your schedule.
Oh, let me see. I got a couple clients in the morning and then a... Oh, damn. I've got a lunch meeting tomorrow. Two men are flying in from a station in New York City. I can't cancel it.
That won't be a problem.
Okay.
Then?
Then... Angie gets out of school, and the bus drops her off at Max's, and then, I go off to work. Sometimes I go and pick her up.
Okay, listen. We're gonna have an undercover officer at school, a woman. If it's all right with you, she'll come here in the morning, take Angie to school, and bring her back in the afternoon, if she can go without seeing Max for a couple of days.
Well, okay, that's all right, but is she gonna be all right every single second?
Yes. We won't let her out of our sight.
Sounds good to me.
All right, we're gonna go. There's a uniformed cop outside your door. If you have any questions, you call me.
I will.
See you tomorrow.
Thank you, Michael.
Thanks, gentlemen.
Thanks a lot.
Something I want you to have.
What? No, just put that away.
Would you just take it from me?
Lloyd, don't.
Would you just take it from me, please?
I could never, ever shoot anybody.
If your life depended on it, I think you could manage. Come on, Jules. I don't think it's gonna come to that, but if it does, I'd feel much better knowing that you have this with you all the time. Okay?
Okay, for you. Good night.
Hi, Angie and Julie. Do it at the beep.
Julie, where are you? What the hell's going on, Julie? Are you there? What was that message you left now? Please, call me.
What's wrong?
I don't know. I was just wondering.
What?
Do you think that Parmenter really did do it?
How can you ask that question?
I don't know. Maybe it's because he keeps telling me that he did.
Listen to you. I'm trying to make sense out of a crazy man.
Girl can't help it. It's what she does for a living. I'll see you tomorrow.
Good night.
What we do is we'll start with an hour a day in the early evening, just as people are coming home from work, and we'll slowly build up a listener base. We'll begin with a few key cities, including Ithaca, where you already have huge numbers. Then, hell, there's probably no stopping you. Something wrong, Dr. Kaiser.
No, I'm sorry. I was just worried about the hot coffee spilling.
I ask you a question, Dr. Kaiser?
Sure, go ahead.
You in some kind of trouble again?
What makes you say that?
I saw the cop who drove you here.
How could you tell that he was a cop?
I just could. They all dress the same.
Why would I be in trouble? What did you mean by again?
I was just asking, Dr. Kaiser. I didn't mean anything by it.
You know something, Billy? Sometimes I wonder if you're getting a little bit too attached to me.
What do you mean?
These aren't social visits. I want to help you to get well.
Oh, please, Dr. Kaiser, please don't send me to another therapist. Please. I like you. I like it here. I am getting better.
I know. So what do you think, Brian? You think she's the right girl for you?
I like her looks.
Mm-hmm.
I like the way she dresses.
Okay.
And I think she's smart.
All right.
I also think she's funny.
Whoa!
Brian, she sounds great. I mean, what more do you want?
I don't know. Maybe it's just a facade. They say the worst killers look like your next-door neighbor. You never know, do you? It's just that I want to be 100% sure.
Well, then you've got a long wait ahead of you, because nothing in this life, especially in relationships, is 100%.
But there's so much about her I don't know.
There's always going to be things about her that you don't understand. But you're just going to have to learn to trust your instincts.
Julie?
Max? What are you doing here?
What do you mean, what am I doing here? I'm worried sick, that's why. Why haven't you returned my calls?
This is Detective Lieberman. This is my,
husband.
Husband, Max Kaiser.
Nice to meet you.
Can I have a moment alone with her, please?
Sure.
Max, I am back on the air in 3 minutes, all right?
I won't keep you. What the hell is going on?
Nothing is going on. The police are here. Everything is under control.
What about Angie?
She's at home with an officer. She's all right.
What's the story with this?
Lieberman?
Yeah.
Michael, you know.
Looks like a real intellectual. Probably got through high school on a correspondence course, huh?
Oh, Max, you... Oh, for... Brilliant!
You just don't get it, do you, Julie? Well, I'm warning you. I'm not going to let you do this. I'm not going to let you destroy this family.
Max, would you please let go of me? I am on the air.
My God. Could have killed you.
Well, I think that that was the idea. Hello, I'm Julianne Kaiser, and tonight's topic is, how do I know that this is Mr. or Ms. Wright? Who am I talking to?
Hi, Julie. My name is Elizabeth.
Hi, Elizabeth. What's on your mind?
Mr. Wrong is on my mind. They got Mr. Wrong.
I don't understand, Elizabeth.
Mr. Wrong screwed up. But next time, Mr. Wrong is going to get Ms. Wright. Do you want to know why?
Why?
Because I'm a fanatic about justice. Because I want to kill you. And I'm willing to die for it.
Hello, are you still there? Hello?
Thanks for keeping an eye on her.
It was my pleasure. Good night, Angie.
Good night. And thanks for whipping my butt at Scrabble, officer.
Angie.
See you tomorrow.
I'm starving, so I'm gonna go make something to eat.
Okay.
She's a great kid.
I'm going to bed, sweetie. Be sure and put that stuff in the dishwasher when you're through, okay?
Okay. What?
Night, Em.
You okay, Mom?
Yeah. I'm just tired.
Night.
I thought you liked my parents.
Angie, look, don't whine. It's just for a couple of days, all right?
I'm not whining. I'm worried about you.
Don't.
Look, Julie, why don't you come with us, huh?
I can't.
It's only an hour's drive.
Max, I've got a show to do.
Then will you do something for me?
What?
Will you stay with me until this is all over? Please?
I don't think that that's a good idea, Max.
What do you want from me, Julie? You want me down on my knees?
Max?
I've always been there for you, Julie, since you're Angie's age. Isn't that worth anything?
Please don't do this.
I can't help myself. I love you.
Max, I'm ready.
Okay.
Just about finished here.
Okay. I love you, sweetheart, and don't you worry. I'll call you right after the show.
Okay.
I will talk to you later, Max.
Fine.
Dr. Kaiser will be right here.
Okay, thanks. need a favor. I want you to run a tape of an old show for me tonight, okay?
What's going on?
Don't ask. I need to borrow your Jeep, too, for a couple hours.
Are you okay?
I'm fine. Now, please, can you do this for me?
Sure. I'll get the keys.
Thanks.
Kaiser, and tonight's topic is creative arguing. Who am I talking to?
My name is Dominique. So what can I do for you, Dominique?
Go on.
My father hit me and called me a...
What?
He said that I'd left the blinds open deliberately because I wanted Parmenter to watch me undress.
Go on.
He was always like that. I was always afraid of his black moods, his temper. I spent my whole childhood trying to figure out what was wrong with me, wondering why I wasn't lovable like other children.
Why didn't you tell me any of this when you came to see me as a child?
Because I was ashamed. Because I hated him. Because I was glad that he was dead. In my mind, what I remember that night, I keep seeing the murderer exactly the same way over and over. The little girl leaving her room, going up the stairs, seeing her murdered parents on the bed, and seeing the killer's shadow on the wall, but then...
What?
But then when I turn and look, I don't see who's throwing that shadow. I don't see who it is.
But you know who it is.
I do.
What are you suggesting, Julie? That you saw the person, but that it wasn't Parmenter? But how? They found the knife in the shed. He was covered in blood.
Yes, but see, he was a hired hand drunk. It would have been so easy to set him up.
What are you saying?
That maybe I framed him. And that maybe the person throwing that shadow was me.
Wouldn't it make more sense that you did see the person, that it was Parmenter, but the horror you felt was so extreme that your mind wouldn't take it in?
But if that's true, then why do I now keep seeing myself on that wall?
Julie,
No, please, just answer the question, Dr. Petrie, yes or no. Is it possible that I have repressed it all these years and that I am the killer?
I told you he was dead when I found him.
I'm not accusing you, Julie. I know it doesn't look like it, but I'm on your side.
Well, you have a very strange way of showing it.
Miss Julie?
Yes?
I don't imagine you'll remember me, ma'am, but I'm Paul Erickson. I was the officer here, you know, the night of the murders.
You're right, I don't remember you. I'm sorry. I've worked very hard at not remembering.
Mike.
What do you got?
I just checked with Dr. Petrie. Your little girlfriend was telling the truth. She was there, but she left around 5.
So?
So plenty. She can't account for all that time.
Julie ran half a mile to the Johnson place, and Harmon went that way. We found him 5 hours later holed up in Ferguson's barn. He'd washed some, tried anyway, but he was still a bloody mess.
Where was Lloyd?
Lloyd? Lloyd wasn't here. He had a girlfriend, Sharon. Sharon Moore, I think it was. He used to sneak out most nights and spend them with her.
What else did you question?
Oh, I don't remember. The Johnsons, Ferguson and his sister. Some kids.
School kids?
Yeah, friends. School kids. The only one I remember is Max. He was a little older. And he and Julie, well, you probably know this. A few years later, they went off and got married.
Max Kaiser?
Yeah, Max Kaiser.
I didn't know he was from Bradford.
Oh, yeah. That little hellraiser was born and grew up right here.
You didn't tell me you and Max were childhood sweethearts.
So?
He knew your parents.
Yeah, he did.
You know what Erickson told me? He said your old man was a mean SOB. He said a lot of people felt he got what he deserved.
He said that?
Why do I get the feeling you're not telling me everything you know?
I told you everything I know.
Listen to me, Erickson's no fool. He's made a couple of calls. Max was at the university in some staff meeting. Lloyd was with one of his little friends.
So what are you saying? They're suspects
what
now?
What I'm saying is that Parmenter didn't kill himself. And if it wasn't you, it was somebody who was trying to protect you.
You think I did it, don't you?
Not sure I want to know.
I'm sorry, all right? I didn't mean to come down on you so hard.
Forget it.
But I still need to know what happened.
I told you what happened, Michael.
Well, no, not. I don't mean just tonight, Julie. I mean 25 years ago.
I thought I told you that, too.
Yeah, but I don't get it. You can't remember? You don't want to remember? What is it?
I was a child, all right? My mind is protecting me. It doesn't want me to remember. Why is that so difficult for you to understand?
What are you yelling at me for? Huh? I'm trying to help you. Can't you see that? Can't you see everything points to you?
You seem in a good mood today, Billy.
I am. You should be, too.
Why?
Because everything's going to be all right now, Dr. Kaiser. You had enough trouble in Bradford as a kid. 25 years ago.
I don't know, Michael. It was something that he said in the middle of our session. I mean, he had no way of knowing about my past.
He was a classmate of yours?
No, not really. He was a senior. I don't think I ever said more than 2 words to him.
Now, I want to explain it one more time to make sure you understand. You don't have to answer my questions.
You do have the right to talk to a lawyer. Do you understand?
I don't need to speak to a lawyer. I didn't do anything wrong.
Can you tell me where you were last Tuesday night?
I don't remember.
You do know who John Parmenter was, though?
Yeah.
Do you remember him from Bradford?
No, not really. Mostly from what happened at Julie's place.
How long have you been in love with Julie?
I don't have to answer that.
Why didn't you tell her who you really were?
I don't know.
Ever been in prison, Billy? Of course not. I gotta tell you, if you did kill him, things will be a lot easier for you if you tell the truth. Billy, did you do it?
Hello? Somebody there?
All over for you.
You scared me to death. Max, I am exhausted. I need some sleep, okay?
You know, it's ironic, Julie. You know what today is?
No, what?
Our anniversary. Today would have been our 15th anniversary.
Max, I really don't have the energy, okay?
Okay, okay. But you can at least open your present, huh?
Look at you, Max. You are a mess.
I know. I tried to drink myself to sleep, but it didn't work. Come on, come on. Just open your present, okay? I think you're really gonna like it. That's my shirt.
I know. I packed it by mistake.
I don't really know anything about this stuff. I only know you love it. I miss you, Julie. I'm sorry for everything. I know I haven't been the easiest man in the world, but you owe me another chance. You do, for everything that I did for you.
Max, why do you keep fighting me on this?
Because I need you. I was there whenever you needed me, remember? I was there for all that horror. And now I need you. I saved you, Julie, from a living hell. And I'm never gonna let you forget that, because I can't forget it.
What do you mean you saved me?
What do you mean, what do you mean? You know what I mean.
I wanna know what you meant by that. I wanna know exactly how you saved me. Tell me.
How dare you say that to me? How dare you? How can you sit there and pretend that that didn't happen at all? You self-centered, ungrateful.
No, that's all right, sweetie. I take these in the kitchen. Okay.
Hello?
Stop digging for answers. You're not going to like what you find. And if you do, Julie, it's going to be too late.
Max?
Yes. He knew me better than anyone else in Bradford, and he knew about Dad. He knew how... Dad terrorized me. It's possible, Lloyd. It's really possible.
It's okay.
We have no information yet. We know that he's in town.
Scaring me. I worry about Angie. Hello?
Hello?
What the hell's going on, Julie? The police are all over my house.
I know that it was you.
What?
Stop digging for answers.
What are you trying to do to us?
Did Daddy do something?
What, sweetie?
Bad?
I don't know. It's all very confusing. I'd give anything to have the answer.
When you really want to, Mom, you will.
You come back here, Julie!
Lloyd!
Are you okay?
Yes.
You were right about Max. I didn't think so at first. But then I figured I'd keep an eye on him, and I followed him here. He led me right through you. So, the nightmare's over.
Is he dead?
I don't think so.
Then you better go for help.
All right, I'll be right back.
Leave it alone, Jules. No one needs to know. Why should they? I did it for both of us. You hated them as much as I did. There's nothing to be afraid of. It's me. I'm begging. Begging you, Jules. It was hard enough all those years. I'm the one who had to live with it. No, please. Don't ruin everything. Please.
I warned you not to dig for answers. I told you you wouldn't like what you found.
I'm sorry, Julie.
You gonna miss this place?
Miss it? I don't think so.
Okay, New York, here we come!
Hi there. It's a dazzling night in the Big Apple. Beautiful New York City, and you're on the air with Dr. Julie Ann Kaiser. And I'm ready to take your call.